Hello, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are. It's currently 10:01 a.m. here in Washington. Hope everyone is doing well. Yeah, so today we're going to be continuing off of what we started yesterday and filling in these intersecting areas with the primary red, yellow, and blue. I was going to try and point my fingers, but I didn't really want to flip you off, so we're not going to do that today. So just to get an idea of what it will look like when it's done, it'll look like this, but just with the circles, right? Yeah, so you can go ahead and get started. Also, this came up earlier, but thank you for the follow. Rigelitis, if that's how you're supposed to say it. So, when I was working on this first rectangle one, a majority of the color in this piece was definitely red. More prominent color, because that had the most, I guess, coverage. So, I know, because I'm doing a series with rectangles, circles, and then finally triangles. So, for this one, I'm going to make the primary color yellow. So, I want to make sure that when I'm filling in, I keep in mind which intersecting parts that will affect. Not clip the table. It's funny because I try and put a different question every day for the QOTD, and I never answer them. So today I'm gonna make sure I answer it first. I'm not a big coffee person. My mom hates the smell, so we don't have like a coffee maker at home, like at all. Like the only coffee I can make at home would be like instant. That way the smell doesn't linger. Like we don't have a coffee pot or anything. We have a coffee grinder, like a mini, like handheld one, that we use that to grind lavender seeds. So I can't use that one. It's cute because I think it was for Christmas last year. My coworkers all pitched in and they got me like a little goodie bag. It was so sweet. Like I miss them so much. They're all so cute. But they got me like a Starbucks mug, and then in it had like their blend of coffee beans. So I was thinking, I was like, I can't use this. But it was really cute of them to do that. So like whenever I get a drink, I'll always gravitate towards like a fruity drink. So like either a tea or like the juice blends. Like my order at Starbucks would be typically the mango dragon fruit, add soy milk. Because I really like creamy flavors. Like, if I'm getting pasta, I always choose, like, an Alfredo. If I'm getting pizza, hot take, I will always get white sauce. So, like, even on another hot take, I like pineapple on pizza. Like, I'm one of those weirdos. But, like, I will put white sauce onto my Hawaiian pizzas. Because, like, I like savory and sweet combos a lot. But I think, like, Red Manera is often too sweet. Like, sometimes it's a bit much for me. And I really like garlic a lot. Like, my mom, when I was little, she cooked a lot with garlic. So I just have a taste for Alfredo. So my go-to drink at Starbucks is usually gonna be the mango dragon fruit. Add strawberry puree and then add soy milk. Like, I was excited when their coconut milk refresher line came out, but the coconut milk is like too thick almost, so it tastes kind of like gummy in your mouth, like it sticks to your tongue. So I always go with soy milk if they have it available. And I always have to get a cake pop for my sister. Like, she gets mad if I don't bring one home for her. Not mad, mad, but like, she'll be upset. She'll see like the cup and be like, "Hey, get something for me." Okay, got the first section done. I keep on wanting to instinctually fully close the caps because I'm just so like trained, like, you know, Sharpies, how they'll die. But like these caps, they are so difficult to open. My God. It's like whenever I'm working on a project, I'll keep them like slightly open. Yeah, so I think I'll make these two yellow as well. That way it kind of keeps the yellow more centralized. Yes, we got all the sections filled in now. So I'm gonna go ahead and do some touch-ups with some white and black.
Thank you.
Cool. So I think this one is done. Yeah, so all the sections are filled in, the chips are done. This one is good to go. Second one, so you have the first rectangle piece, and then the second circle one for the series. So I'm gonna go ahead while this one's drying, get started with the penciling on the triangle one. Yeah, I gotta go grab my paint palettes. I'll be right back. Okay, I am back. Thank you.
Thank you.
I clipped. See that? I clipped. Thank you. Sorry, didn't mean to clip. Yeah, my setup right now, I have a Bluetooth mic attached to my headsets. Because, like, I don't like the big, like, standing mics. Like, I don't like the idea of having, like, something in my face all the time. Got all the base shapes outlined. So just gonna go ahead and do another layer on any spots that are less opaque. Now I just have to be very careful not to clip. So I know me, I get a lot less precise and careful whenever I like fill in large areas. Fat chips are done. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and start coloring in this one. And for this one, I'd like the primary color to be blue. So I probably want to make sure I color in probably those in blue. Clipped.
Thank you.
Okay. All filled in. Just gonna go ahead and do touch-ups, fill in any less colored in areas, touch-ups in white and black. Okay, I think I got just about everything on here. Cool. Almost exactly 3 hours. Nice. Okay, so this abstract series is done. Go over what the series was. It was base shapes filled in with primary colors, kind of like a back to basics type theme. We got this first rectangle one that we did on Friday. And then circle one that we started yesterday and finished today. And finally, triangles that we did all today. Yeah, looking at these, I definitely like how the first two have a lot more white space, a lot less, or a lot more negative space is still there. I think this one, everything is more centralized, like there's no defined like edge, everything seems pretty consistent wise. So yeah. Cool, I'm glad I got that these done today. So I think I said yesterday I want to do custom shirts. I'm still waiting though for those to come in the mail. So I might tomorrow do sketch cards or either just a different illustration series because I definitely want to keep using these theme pens. They're really nice. They definitely flow or like draw better on a flat surface. Definitely challenging on the canvas because it has the more rough texture. So I definitely want to play with these a bit more. Okay, so I'd like to thank everyone for popping in today, and I will be back again tomorrow, 10 a.m. PST. Y'all have a good one.